Backstage has landed within the TAS portal in VMware Tanzu Application Service 4.0. If you don't know, Backstage is a popular open source platform that enables organizations to build software catalogs and developer portals. Now let's drill into some of these new features with the TAS portal. The software catalog embedded in the TAS portal allows software developers to search for and register applications in the catalog. This concept enables developers to rapidly discover and reuse existing software packages or APIs rather than having to recreate the wheel themselves. Runtime resources have also been added within the TAS portal, so you can see how certain components are performing within Tanzu Application Service. Last but not least, the TAS portal also includes the application accelerators, which enables developers to kickstart application development by providing curated best practice templates for use within an organization. Now that we know what the TAS portal is, let's take a test drive of the portal and see it in action. I have the TAS portal catalog view loaded here, and I have pre-populated my catalog with some example services and components, but I actually want to go ahead and register a new component, which will represent me adding a new application to the catalog so that other folks can see it, and build in some of my own organizational structure and team structure as well. So I'm going to flip over to GitHub here, and I've built a kind of sample catalog to use, and this is actually going to reference a Spring Music application I've deployed in Tanzu Application Service, so then we can actually see some of those runtime resources populate as well within the portal. We go ahead and click Register Entry and apply this URL. It's going to analyze that catalog, and here are the different components it's injecting into the system. I have my component, which is the actual application itself. I have a high-level domain, or kind of like an organization. I'm calling that Kuhn Labs domain. I've got groups set up, user set up, different locations. So I think we're ready to go ahead and hit import. That import finished. So let's go back to the catalog. We can see that my Spring Music Home Lab application has been loaded into the catalog. I'm going to drill into this here. We're starting to see mappings of group ownership and system ownership within this component or this application. If I go into the TAS runtime resources, I should see things populating here. And we can see that the app, the build processes are loaded, the route my app is using. I'm going to actually go into the app view here. We can see that this ownership level here taking place as well, where the top level is the domain, going down to the system level, which kind of represent a grouping of applications. The Home Lab is the Spring Music Home Lab is the actual application listed here as well. And you know, this structure is very flexible and can be molded into your own specifications. We can see what foundation we're using, when the app was created. If you scroll down here, we can see some CPU and memory utilization. I'm not using any task in here. I have one application index, one application instance with index 0. The route again is showed, and some logs as well. So that's a quick view of the runtime resources. Now let's jump into one of my favorite features in the TAS portal, the application accelerators. And as I mentioned before, the accelerators represent golden best practice templates to use within an organization. We have provided some sample templates or accelerators to use, and we'll provide the ability to add more templates in the future. Now, if we select the Node Express template, we can give it a name. I'm going to leave it as a default name, and I'm going to uncheck the tap deployment resources because I'm deploying to Tanzu Application Service. I'm going to hit next and generate the accelerator. Now we can go ahead and explore the file, and you can see this is where we start to see the real magic of the accelerators, where I get a README file, I get instructions on how to deploy my application to my platform, CF push with my manifest. I think we all know and love that experience. Also get some sample code we can look at. Obviously with a more built-out template, we might get a little bit more code to work with, but this is just a very classic sample application to use. And we also get a manifest YAML. So if we wanted to control some of the different components of how this application deploys to Tanzu Application Service, we can do that here as well. And that's it, a very simple accelerator, but you could start to see how this will really improve some organizational best practices going forward. If you like what you saw here today, make sure to scan the QR code or navigate to the link below, and that will take you to the Tanzu Tech Zone site so you can stay up to date on all the latest and greatest Tanzu and Tanzu Application Service news.